Oh my God, let's do a Sephora VIB sale haul. Okay, technically for me, this is not actually a VIB sale haul. It's just a regular Sephora haul because I am sick and tired of the stress of having to purchase everything, wait for it to arrive, sit down and film a video, edit it, make sure everything's uploaded on time before the sale ends. I'm sick of it. I've been doing that twice a year for the past several years. It's stressful. It always feels like a crazy time crunch. I was like, you know what? It's just not worth that stress. And I really want to make sure that I get these hauls up for you guys before the sale ends. Cause I know for me personally, like if I'm watching a haul after the fact, I'm like, well, now I don't really want to buy that because I could have just gotten it at a discount versus if it's when the sale is still going on and you do want to pick something up, then you still can at that discounted price. So this time around, I did decide to forego the discount, even though that was like a knife to my chest, but it's worth it to lower the stress levels. So let's talk about everything that I purchased that I would have wanted to purchase at a discount. Trust me, I wanted to. And I also thought I would include some items that I've received in PR recently that I wanted to buy during the sale that now I don't have to because thankfully I did get them in PR. So I'm sure you can just like tell how heavy this is. There's a lot in here. Let's just dive into it. This is the first thing I picked up. I'm so excited to sniff this. This is the Josie Maran Body Butter in Vanilla Vibes. I did see that they had a few different scents that sounded right up my alley, but this, of course, is the one that I had to purchase. It has notes of vanilla bean and juniper berries. Look at this little label. Is that not so cute? And this is technically the refill packaging, but I thought that this was way cuter and just handier than the original jar that it comes in, so I went ahead and got this. Okay. If you'll excuse me, I just got that all over my laptop. I do not feel good about the ability of my laptop to survive that spill, but the show must go on. So let's just give this a little rub. Ooh, that feels very nice. Dang. That's just not what I was hoping for. Feels really good. I absolutely love the texture of that. The smell to me is like sour shortbread cookies. Fail number one. Let's just continue on with body care while we're at it. I got a really nice PR package from Sol de Janeiro, which I was super excited about because you guys know I love Sol de Janeiro fragrances. I included their original body wash and body cream in my VIB sale recommendations video that just went up. So I got a couple body washes from them. This is just the OG. They actually just repackaged it. I thought this was a new one, but just seems to be some new packaging. But I was most excited about this one. This is the Beige Flor fragrance, and I love the scent of this, but unfortunately the body cream just doesn't quite work for me. I've told you guys before that it just like doesn't really fully absorb. So I felt bummed that I can't use that fragrance in my body care routine, but now I can because I have the body wash. Oh my gosh, that's good. Saint Tropez launched a new self-tanner called the Self-Tan Supreme Violet Bronzing Mousse. Something about this just drew me in and made me want to buy it. This is supposed to give you a natural deep olive tan. Probably those claims. I was like, we'll see about that. Because you guys know how seriously I take my self-tan recommendations. I'm so, so picky about self-tanner. If you are new here, I have a series on my channel called Self-Tan Showdown where I compare a bunch of different self-tanners all in one video. And I think I have now done 4 of those videos total. So I've truly reviewed a crazy amount. And if you have not seen all of them, I will list those below so you can check them out. But my standards are high for a good self-tan. We'll see if this meets my standards. I'll keep you guys posted on all of this, of course. Ooh, last thing I have for body care is from 54 Thrones. This is their Cloud Rapid Hydration and Barrier Repair Cream. I have the original version of this. I love it. I've recommended it before. It's so, so nourishing, deeply hydrating. This has a different fragrance. It is Kenyan hibiscus and Moroccan rose. Ooh, that is what it looks like. Like, oh my God, this is insane, you guys. I use the original fragrance as my hand cream every night because it's just, it's so good. And I do still prefer that one over this rose scent. The original has like a subtle vanilla scent, But if you do prefer florals, this is a nice light one. Let's move on to skincare next. With the exception of one product, everything in this skincare category was sent to me in PR. I figured since I have these things, it might be helpful for you guys to see textures up close, because there's a few things here that I was definitely really curious about. So I can't be the only one. I know that you guys usually like the same things I do. The first thing that I cannot wait to test out is the In Beauty Project Mineral Sun Glow SPF 43. This comes in two different shades. I have fair medium. It's also available in medium deep. Let's do a hand swatch while I talk about ingredients. Oh my gosh, such cute packaging. I love it. The only sunscreen active in this is zinc oxide. The ingredients that In Beauty Project highlights include vitamin C, rice extract, peptides, and something called Hydroviton 24, which is supposed to be a combination of natural moisturizing factors that are supposed to keep your skin hydrated for hours. Wow, that's glowy. So this looks to have a light kind of peachy hue. It feels like a gel lotion. I mean, that glow is beautiful. I feel like a little bit of that mixed in with a foundation would be stunning. And aside from the ingredients that they called out themselves, this actually has quite a few others that are really beneficial for our skin, including things like olivine 1000, squalane, niacinamide, resveratrol, bisabolol, allantoin, lots of different plant extracts, amino acids, urea, the list goes on. So impressed by that, and also impressed by the fact that there are actually several different peptide ingredients that are towards the top of the label. It's not like one of those products that says it has peptides, but really just has one and it's very last on the label. So I like that when a brand is actually delivering on some of their claims. Here's what this looks like now that it's dried down a bit. That is stunning. I'm excited to play around with that. I got a couple products from Danessa Myricks. I'm really curious to try these. She obviously has amazing makeup products, but I haven't tried any skincare from her. The first is a moisture repair balm serum, which sounds right up my alley. Interesting. It looks like a cleansing balm. So this is supposed to be a balm to serum that intensely hydrates, repairs, and soothes with their moisture repair complex, which is a blend of 16 nourishing ingredients. Okay, it's feeling greasy right off the bat. This is such a strange texture. It literally just feels like a cleansing balm. They call out the use of Centella Asiatica, hyaluronic acid, and blue tansy flower extract. I'm not loving the feel of this. It definitely is just something that feels greasy. But if you have dry skin, maybe it's something you would love at night. It also has camellia seed oil, jojoba seed oil, kokum butter, shea butter, sunflower seed oil, sea buckthorn oil, squalane. Lots of goodies in here. Makes sense that there are several different oils because it just, yeah, it definitely feels quite oily. It does have a really beautiful finish though. I don't know. Definitely not going to be something that I want to put on my skin just because I lean oily, but I will see if my mom wants to try it out. She's quite a bit drier than me. The other new launch I got from them sounds very intriguing to me. This is the Yummy Skin Mattifying Water Powder Serum. So a serum with skincare ingredients, like they call out niacinamide, hyaluronic acid, mushroom extract. It also has niacinamide, zinc PCA, squalane, gluconolactone. So a lot of beneficial ingredients for sure, but the thing that is supposed to help with sebum production is clay. So this has kaolin, however you say that, in it, which says it will mop up excess sebum without a drying effect. Come on. Okay, this packaging is a huge no for me. You can't squeeze it. Am I missing something here? Do not shake, just tap the bottom. Oh, man. Interesting. Oh, I see. So you can like push on the bottom of this and then it squeezes out. Ooh, very, very, very lightweight. Water-like texture with a tiny bit of slip. That's actually something I want to try out because I like the idea of having some sort of absorbent in a product like this so that then I can use my glowy products after and I don't have to worry about looking greasy. It Cosmetics came out with a gel cream version of their Confidence in a Cream, and I absolutely love the texture of the original Confidence in a Cream, but I cannot use it because the fragrance does irritate my skin. Ooh, I like this packaging, like clear aqua. I believe this still has fragrance. Mm-hmm, it does. This actually kind of smells good though. So it looks like there are several different fragrant components and just fragrance also. They are towards the bottom of the label, but you can smell it. This is quite fragrant. I will still show you guys the texture though in case you are not irritated by fragrance. Ugh, this is the type of thing I would love. Oh my goodness, here. Excuse me, let me show you that dip. That feels so refreshing. It feels cold. Oh my God, wait, I'm sad. I'm gonna try this because this feels unreal, but I am very scared it's going to irritate my skin. This isn't one of those gels that just turns watery. Like, this has such a nice viscosity to it. I am obsessed. This has niacinamide, a peptide complex, squalane, and an oil control system in it, which includes ingredients like zinc PCA and gluconolactone. Dang! I have to try this. I have to. I will probably regret it, but I have to. I'm not sure if this is going to be available by the time this video goes up, but in case it is, I wanted to include this because I have been loving this. This is the new It Cosmetics Hello Sunshine Invisible Hydrating Serum Sunscreen. That's a mouthful. So cute too. What I love about this is that it's very reminiscent to me of an Asian sunscreen. It has that extra liquidy element to it, but it's not like one of those that has quite a high amount of alcohol, so it dries down super quickly and you can't really feel it. Like, there still is slip to this, but in a very moisturizing, nourishing way, not in a greasy way. I just think it feels so nice and it leaves such a beautiful glow on my skin. It is a chemical sunscreen, so the filters in it are avobenzone, homosalate, octisalate, and octocrylene. It has panthenol, hyaluronic acid, and this does have fragrance, so I'm being a hypocrite. It's just not quite as potent as that moisturizer, in my opinion. Like, I can smell a little bit of it, but I'm mainly just smelling sunscreen, and this doesn't irritate my skin. Oh, I just really love it, and I am excited to see what they come out with next in the sunscreen category, because I believe this is the first sunscreen launch from them that doesn't have pigment in it, like makeup pigment, that is. I wanted to include the new Laneige Bouncy and Firm Sleeping Mask because I have tried sleeping mask type products from them in the past, and they have just ended up really irritating my skin. So I was excited to see that this is not an overnight mask that is supposed to exfoliate. I think that has been the biggest issue with me with their overnight products before. Well, that and the fact that they're mixed with fragrance. This one, on the other hand, is just supposed to be more so like a plumping, hydrating type of product. So they call out the inclusion of things like a collagen complex, peptides, hydromelt glow capsules, which are supposed to mimic skin lipids. You actually can see that. I don't know if the camera will pick it up, but I can see those little capsules in here in the texture. This also has hyaluronic acids, green tea, a probiotic lysate, and several other really nice hydrating, calming, nourishing ingredients, things like allantoin, adenosine. Okay, I am seeing some fragrant components here. So this has linalool, geraniol, citronellol, and a couple others as well. So be aware of that if you are sensitive to fragrance. Oh my God, this feels so good. I can smell the faintest amount of fragrance. To me, this just does not have a super potent smell. The fragrance is pretty faint. So hopefully I can get away with using this. Cause wow, does that feel good? My God, you guys, like my goodness. Dang, that feels good. I've also tried several Laneige moisturizers that are not like overnight exfoliating ones. And to be honest, I've never really been super impressed by any of them. So I think that's why I'm especially excited about this, because so far that texture just feels incredible. Last for skincare is something that one of you guys told me about. This is the Pharmacy Lip Smoothie Honey Vanilla Vitamin C and Peptide Lip Balm. You guys just know me in the sense that I love that. Oh my God, so cute. Oh. I'm not so far getting a ton of vanilla from this, but the honey smell is so yummy. Oh my God, it smells so good. It's not even like too much honey. It's just like a dash of honey with sweetness. Okay, here is the texture. Feels really nice. Like, you can just see on my finger that that's melty. Let's put it on. Okay, I love it. Wow. This does feel very similar to the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask, but I do think this one's a little bit thinner. They're not identical. This one's a bit slipperier. I'll keep you guys posted, but wow. I knew that I needed to purchase this the second that it dropped. It's the new Super Goop sunscreen called Protect Tint Daily SPF Tint. This is an SPF 50 tinted sunscreen, which is not as easy as you would think to find. And not only is it an SPF 50, they have multiple shades. So this is what it looks like. What's up with the fingers? Ew. I got the shade 22W for my self-tan days. So this is a combination sunscreen, actually. It has zinc oxide, homosalate, and octisalate. Okay, so not like super liquidy right off the bat. A little bit of drip, but I'm getting like a thicker first impression. Uh-huh. Oh, very, very creamy. Wow. I know there's a lot on the back of my hand, but like still you can tell when something's thicker. Okay. It's giving makeup. Okay. I'll do that again with less product. Interesting. So this is supposed to have a barely there feel with light coverage.
Okay, let's do like a dot.
I mean, nothing about the way that this feels so far would make me say that it's barely there. It's definitely thicker, but not in a bad way. It feels really moisturizing. I can just like feel the creamy element to it. Not really much to call out here in terms of ingredients other than just like hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, things you can find in most products, but this is fragrance free. Kosas dropped a new sunscreen. This is like the sister to their Dream Beam sunscreen that they launched last year. That one I have reviewed before. It's really nice. It has like a slight peachy hue. This is the Dream Beam Sunlit Comfy Smooth sunscreen that has like a bronzing color to it. This contains peptides, ceramides, hyaluronic acid, and allantoin. It has SPF 40. It is a completely mineral sunscreen with zinc oxide as the active ingredient. Oh, wow. That's like quite pigmented. It does sheer out. Okay, so that is what that swatches out like. Definitely does lean warm, but I like that it's not looking like crazy orange. I mean, anything with a warm undertone is gonna pull orange on my fair skin. But when I have a self tan on, I would imagine that that would be really, really nice. I'll keep you posted. All right, let's move on to makeup. A few things here that I was super excited to try out. I wanted to pick up another House Labs foundation, but in a deeper shade, because the one that I have is for my fair skin. So I picked up 200 light medium neutral on a whim. We'll see if this ends up being a good match. Oh yeah, I think I should be good with that. I just cannot stop wearing this mixed with the glow primer lately. I have it on right now. It's my go-to. It is fabulous. Highly recommend. It Cosmetics launched a new CC cream, and historically I just have not been the hugest fan of their CC creams because they feel heavy. They're just like very makeup-y and extra, extra shiny on my skin. But when I saw that they launched a natural matte version, I was like, okay, I'll try you. So this is the CC Plus Natural Matte Color Correcting Pore Refining Full Coverage Cream with Skin Balancing Serum. It's a broad spectrum SPF 40. The Skin Balancing Serum is Air Lycium Hyaluronic Acid and 3% Lentil Seed Complex.
Okay.
Combination, why'd I just shake that like that? Combination sunscreen with titanium dioxide and salicylol and octisalate.
Oh wait, what shade did I get?
Medium. Again, obviously, in an attempt to match my tan. Ooh, I think that that might be nice. Okay, very creamy. Definitely not on the lightweight side at all. That feels heavy. Again, I obviously used quite a bit. Ew. Let me try to do, like, literally a tiny bump.
Okay. Let's see if that...
Oh, I might be able to get away with that. I was gonna say, I feel like a lot of the times products like this just don't have the best blend, so you need to use more. Okay, that's much better. Ooh, and I can see like the natural matte. That actually looks beautiful.
Or does it? Does it look dry?
Time will tell. I got the new Dior Forever Glow Star Filter because I am currently working on my glowy primer showdown. I have so many, I almost dropped that. So many glowy primers, I definitely didn't need another one, but to make that showdown complete, I felt like I had to include this. I got the shade 2. Ooh. Much lighter weight than the It Cosmetics CC cream. That feels really nice and hydrating. Good slip. I feel like this will be beautiful.
Pretty. Oh my gosh.
I did want to quickly call out the Merit Solo Shadows. I feel like these have very mixed opinions. I personally have been loving them. So I picked up the shade Studio and I have been wearing it quite a bit. This is very, very creamy in texture, but surprisingly easy to work with. Like it just kind of instantly starts to turn into more of like a satin matte when you blend it out. Look at that. And this stays put. It does not crease on my lids. I normally never wear cream shadows like this because they always end up creasing. No creasing with this for me. Of course, after I purchased that, they sent it to me in PR. This is just like a thing for me where if there is something I really want, I'll buy it and then like 2 days later get it in PR. So I'm gifting one of those away, but they also sent me Social, which compared to Studio is much more cool toned. It's like a bit purpley in undertone. So I'll show you guys a little swatchy swatch next to Studio.
Mm.
I feel like that would be stunning on blue eyes. Pretty. I'm excited to try that. Benefit has recently launched a couple new brow products that are very, very small. And if you watch my VIB recommendations video, then you'll know that I am loving the micro nano type brow pencils. So this is the Precisely My Brow Detailer. I picked it up in warm golden blonde. Let's check it out. Oh my God, yes. Look at how freaking tiny that is. Can't wait. YSL launched some new lip products called their Love Shine, which is supposed to be a high shine caring lipstick. And you guys know me in high shine. I picked up the shade 205 Nude Self, but for once I hadn't tried that out yet before I got all of them in PR. So thank you so much to YSL. So excited. I'm gonna swatch all of these for you guys quick. So this one, oh, that's gorgeous. That is shade 44. Wow. I was really hoping these would not have the smell that the other YSL lip products in this kind of packaging have. It is so gross. It's like this artificial peach ring. Oh, hate it. Dang, but that's beautiful, you guys. I might have to suck it up. Next, we have 122. Oh, that's stunning too. Oh my God. Well, that might be something that looks too orange on me, actually. This one is 150. Yeah, that I think would probably pull too warm. 201, this is getting so messy. 202, oh heck, that's good. And last is 204. The shine is beautiful. They definitely have a very slick, slippery texture, but not in an oily way. And if it wasn't for the smell, I would be obsessed. Last for makeup is the Tatcha The Kissu Lip Tint. I picked this up because it has sunscreen in it. It's an SPF 25. They had three different shades and I thought that, is it Camellia? I feel like I always say that wrong and you guys have told me what it is and I can't remember. We'll go with that. I thought that that looks the most promising for me. Really pretty luxe packaging. That is what the bullet looks like. Let's do, ooh, that feels nice. That's super pretty. Has a really nice creamy texture. Beautiful shine. Nice. Excited. All right, let's wrap this video up with hair. Colorwell came out with a leave-in conditioner called the Money Mist, which is supposed to be a luxe light leave-in conditioner for glossy, expensive looking hair. So obviously I had to buy it. I want to try it. Living Proof has a new styling product called just Blowout. It is supposed to give you a faster, easier, salon-worthy blowout. I love Living Proof styling products. I feel like it's definitely one of my top three brands for styling. So I just wanted to test this out because I had a feeling it would be good. And it also has heat protection. So 2-in-1. Kerastase sent me this collection that I am very intrigued by. This is called, what is it called? The names of their products are always so absurd. I never, okay. K Premier. Okay, so all of these have the word decalcifying and reparative on them. And then the two ingredients they call out are glycine and citric acid. So it seems to be very focused on damaged hair. I am very excited to try these. I have a shampoo, a conditioner, a hair mask, a rinse out treatment, a serum filler. So a leave-in that provides heat protection. That's great. Oh wait, I forgot there's one more product in this collection because I just tested it out. It is the gloss. I tested a new shampoo and conditioner a few days ago that just has been making me have some bad hair days. Just did not agree with me. My hair was looking really dry and like just not like its normal self. So I like this. I feel like it brought my hair back to life. And like still didn't get rid of the wave that I had there because sometimes that can happen with an oil. I'm so excited about this. Oribe did send it to me, but I 100% would have purchased it if they didn't. It is their Gold Lust Dry Heat Protection Spray, meaning it is an aerosol mist. And you guys know I've been really into aerosols for heat protection. Super excited to try this one out because I love, love, love the smell of their products. So if I can get that in a heat protectant, sold. Okay. This is something I literally was walking out the house to go find yesterday. I wanted to run to Sephora one last time before filming this video in the hopes of finding this. This is the new K18 Airwash Dry Shampoo. And I had a feeling it wouldn't be in stores yet, but I was like, I just need to check. I really want to try it. And what do you know? It was sitting on my front step in a PR package. So thank you so much to K18. That worked out perfectly. I did test this out yesterday and I posted a first impression TikTok slash reels on it. I'll list that below if you haven't seen it. It wasn't like a full first impression because I did already have dry shampoo in my hair. But in my defense, that dry shampoo just didn't really work. So my hair still looked greasy. And how can I not try this the second that I get it? So what is unique about this is that it's not a dry powder. powdery aerosol. It's actually a wet mist. So it's something that when you spray it, makes your hair look damp at first, but then it'll dry, or you can use a blow dryer on it and then it's like completely refreshed. So I'm super curious to try this out when I don't already have product in my hair, but I will say that when I looked at the before and after results, I was not super impressed. Like, I feel like my hair didn't look all that different. It was better for sure, but it wasn't something that like transformed the look of my roots. So we'll see. Wait, I cannot forget to shout this out. This is the last product, last but certainly not least. Killian launched a new perfume called Sunkissed Goddess. And if you've been watching my videos for the past couple months, you know that I am obsessed with their princess perfume right now. It's so, so, so good. And I have a very big perfume collection. So the fact that I am that obsessed with that says a lot. So I'm hoping that this is just gonna be my summertime version of that. This is described as a fresh solar fragrance with key notes of bergamot, tiare flower, and coconut. Okay, I like this packaging so much better than Princess. I hate the Princess packaging. It's not cute, but this is very cute. Definitely looks more luxe, which it should for the crazy price tag. Has this really pretty detailing on the side. Much better. I'm nervous. I don't think I like it. No. Obviously, I need to let this sit on my skin and see how it evolves throughout the day. But so far, I'm kind of just getting like baby powder. I don't smell any coconut. Gosh, dang it. Well, that was not the best note to end this video on. Now I'm sad. All right. Wow. Let's wrap this video up. I know that this was also an insanely long one, so we've had a couple of really long videos back to back. Thank you so much for watching until the end if you have made it this far. If you did and you would like to see more from me, please don't forget to give this a thumbs up, subscribe, click on that notification bell, send my channel to a friend. That really helps to support me, and your support means the world to me. Thank you for watching my videos. I love the freaking heck out of you guys. Make sure to stay tuned for my next one because that will be up in a few days. But until then, I hope you have a great few days. And I hope I start liking this perfume.